Hi everyone, my name is Dr. BJ, and today we're going to do another lesson on bullying, but it's from the bystander's perspective. We're doing a bullying series and learning about the victim, learning about the bystander today, and we've also learning just the different types of bullying. So just a brief overview. Verbal bullying, it really involves using your words to hurt a person. So that's teasing, making fun of, spreading rumors of a person, right? And when we think of physical bullying, you're actually touching or hitting the person, kicking the person, or using an object to hurt the person. Social bullying is, it involves a relationship with you and, let's say, friends or a friend, where that person is telling another person or a group of people not to play with you or not to interact with you or to be friends with you. And cyberbullying usually involves that of technology and social media. So that's using your phones, using your computers, emails, social media like Instagram or TikTok or Facebook to send mean messages, pictures, or threats to a person. And we know that bullying involves all of these different types of bullying, but it involves when someone says or does something mean to someone with the intention of hurting them. So what you're going to learn today is, what is a bystander? Why do people stand by when bullying occurs? And what can a bystander do? And then we're going to learn about another story from the bystander's perspective about jailer. And it's called weird. So what is a bystander? A bystander is someone who sees a situation but may or may not know what to do. They may think others will act or may be afraid to do something. It's someone who is present when a situation happened and they're put in a position to possibly do something about the situation or discourage the person from bullying the other person, but they still do not interrupt the situation. So that's what a bystander is. Have you ever been a bystander to something that has happened and you did not act? Like, let's say a friend fell down in the hallway and you just stood there and just looked. Did you go by and help? Did you ask them if they needed help? Or someone who was being sick in the restroom, and you saw it happen, did you just stand there and watch and laugh? Or did you go and tell a teacher or get help for that person? So now you know an example of what a bystander is. And I'm going to tell you, as I have been going through all of this bullying and thinking about my experience, I started thinking about, what do people know what to do when they're a bystander? Do they really know what to do? So let's think about it. What do people do when an accident happened? What do? Who do you call? When you see an accident happen, do you just run? Do you continue on with your everyday life? Do you get help? What do you do? What do you do when there's a fire? What do you do when there's a fight? What do you do when someone is hurt? What do you do? Does anyone have an answer? Well, the first thing you should think of doing is taking action, right? Because if there's a fire, someone's hurt, the first thing you think about doing is, I need to get on my phone and call 911, right? To get help. Or what can I do to help the person? Can I go over and see if they need help? So just get help, right? Find some, or if you can't help, get someone who can. So that's what most people usually do, right? But today we're experiencing something around the world where when someone is hurt, guess what we start doing? Do you see those children or young people with their cell phone, they start recording it, right? So that's what people do. They ignore the victim, they laugh, they taunt. They may even join in the bullying, or they may record the situation or incident, and later on, what do they do with the recording? They upload it to the internet to cause even more emotional harm to the person. Yes, and when you upload information that you've, when you upload a situation that you have seen that you know was painful and hurtful to someone, you don't add injury to them more by uploading it to the internet so more people can join in making fun of them. So that's what some bystanders do. So let's pause for a minute. What type of bystander do you think you are? What type of bystander? And as I thought about today and what I wanted to talk to you about as far as the bystander's perspective, I wanted you to think of this song. Because this is a song that I thought of as I was looking, reviewing bullying and what I should share with you today. Now, many of you may not know this song because it's by Michael Jackson. And I start thinking of the bullying. A bully is a person who really think that they're bad, right? Okay, so here is Michael Jackson's "But a Little Boy," who's not Michael Jackson, singing a song called "I'm Bad." Do y'all know this song? I want you to see just a short clip of it. Let's turn that up a little. So that's teasing, right? But do you see his boys in the background? Do you think they believe they're bad?
So what's up?
The hand movement, the gestures. Do you see all of that? Okay, so now as we look at this video, right? Look at the clothes they have on, the headbands. The do-rags. And I'm going to stop this video right here. Do you think that they're bad? Is that what bad looks like? A person who acts like this, a person who walks like this. Is that what most bullies look like? Let's play the rest of the video. Who's bad? everybody doing wrong, right? But let's see the reaction to the young boy. The others.
The way it goes down, huh?
Okay, so that was just something fun to watch, but it's a video about a group of boys who believe that they are what? That they're bad, right? That they're bad. So today we're gonna talk a little bit more about a bystander. We know that bullies believe they're bad. Sometimes people who follow bullies believe that they're bad too. And they do, and they say things, and they copy the bully, and they join in bullying the victim. So this is what we are going to learn more about. How does the person who is the bystander feel? Why do they join in and bully the victim also? So we're going to learn through a story called Dare.
Hi everyone. Today I'm going to read you a story called Dare. Written by Aaron Frankel and illustrated by Paula Heafy. Dare. A story about standing up to bullying in schools. For all children, young and old, who have been involved in bullying, don't lose sight of who you are. Know yourself, be yourself, and remember, your brightest star shines from within. Hi, my name is Jayla. And I'm scared. See that girl? That's Sam. She's tough. She picked on me a lot last year, but I never stood up for myself. I didn't dare. No one else stood up for me. They didn't dare. Sam says, what a loser. I think I know why. Nice hair. That game is for babies. They've been bullied too.
And that's Sam and a friend doing that, right?
Then one day Sam started picking on a girl named Louisa instead of me. Louisa's nice. She smiled and laughed and wears what she likes. Those boots are weird, she told her.
And those are the bystanders.
I felt relief. I wasn't the one being bullied. I felt bad for Louisa, but good for me. I tried to mind my own business, But Sam said things to me about Louisa every day. There, Sam. Aren't Louisa's boots weird? Don't you think she tells the weirdest jokes? I didn't know what to say. If I didn't agree, she'd bully me next. But if I didn't say anything, why do I feel so bad? Stars, how lame. I remember the way I felt when I was bullied. When no one dared to stand up for me. I never thought I'd be the one just standing by. Nerd. Then one day, hey, Jayla, truth or dare, go tell Louisa I think her hair is weird. I was scared, so I took the dare. Now I feel bad. Louisa, for Louisa, and bad for me. This isn't the kind of person I want to be. I dare to tell Louisa she can't sit there. What can I do? What can I say? I take Sam's dares because I'm scared. But then I feel even more scared and alone. Maybe Sam is just using me. What do you think? If it were up to me, I'd tell Sam, hey Sam, that's really mean. Or, I'm going to tell the teacher. Or, why are you always picking on people? Or, I won't be part of this anymore. Stop it! But Sam never stops. She keeps acting tough and making dares. Maybe she knows that I feel scared. One day when Sam wasn't around, I saw Louisa. She was sitting by herself. Her boots were in the trash. I wanted to say, I'm sorry, but the only words I could think of were, what and if? What if I talk to Louisa and Sam finds out? What if Sam starts calling me a loser again? What if things get worse? But what could be worse than feeling scared all the time? And what have I lost? I lost my style, my stars, my laughter, my confidence, my courage, my kindness. I have lost a lot. So has Louisa. And that isn't fair. The truth is, there are people who care and who stand up for others, like my dad. Let's think of some ways you can stand up for yourself and Louisa. My friends, stop picking on her. Teacher, thank you for letting me know, Will. The teacher, we don't do that at our school. So I've been thinking about what about making my own dear. Tell her how you really feel. Stand up and tell Louisa the truth. Should she do it? Let's find out. I still feel scared, but I take the dare. Louisa, I'm sorry. I didn't stand up for you. I found your boots. Do you want to play? Sure. I imagine what I will say if Sam finds out and bullies me. What can I say? You played with Louisa. I sure did. You wear just like her. Wearing and loving it. You can't sit here anymore. Fine with me. If everyone joins together, we can all play a part in making things better. We don't have to do what Sam says. Can you help, Mr. C? We need to talk to the teachers about it. We're playing my way. That's Sam. The teacher, Sam, you can either follow the rules or sit out. The choice is yours. There's Sam. Do you think Sam liked that? And remember, what did they do? They got together. They joined together and helped each other. Now Louisa's being herself again. Love those polka dots, Louisa. Thanks. Cool. Cute boots, Louisa. When Sam calls her weird, Louisa acts like she doesn't care. And I act like I'm not scared. And guess what? I'm not the only one. Stop bullying. I discovered something really amazing. The more I act like I'm not scared, the more I really don't feel scared. It's true. And the more Sam thinks that I'm not scared, the more she leaves Louisa and me alone. Now that's what I call truth and dear. The end.
So how did you like that story? And this is in a series of books on bullying. Again, it's from the perspective of teaching and educating youths about what bullying is, learning about what bullying is like for the victim, the bystander, and also the bully. So I hope you enjoyed the story about Jayla and what? Being a bystander. So let's go back to what we were talking about as far as we learned about being a bystander. We know what it is. So what did we learn from the story? Why didn't Jayla help Louisa? Do you remember why? So just think about it. Anyone? Why didn't Jayla help Louisa? So we think about that a few seconds. And give your answer to your teacher. Why didn't Jayla help Louisa? Have you said your answer? Well, if you said that she didn't help Louisa because she was scared and being bullied by Sam also, you are correct. So how did Sam make Louisa feel? I think I just said it just now. How did she make her feel when she bullied her? How did Sam make Louisa feel? Happy? Sad? Scared? She made her feel scared, yes. And she made her feel sad. So what did Sam make Louisa do? And I have make Louisa do to Louisa, but it made Jayla do to Louisa. Bully her too, right? Because she was telling her mean things. Remember Sam was telling Jayla mean things to do to Louisa? Yes, she did. What did Jayla do to stop Sam's dares? Because she dared her, right? I dare you to tell her that those boots are those polka dot boots were ugly, right? She was talking about those boots. She didn't like those polka dot boots. Do you think she didn't like the polka dot boots because they were really cute and pretty, but she wanted Sam to feel sad about having nice boots? Louisa about having nice boots, but Louisa also had pretty hair too, nice wavy hair. And she was happy and she dared Jayla to tell Louisa that her hair wasn't pretty. That's not nice, is it? And guess what Jayla did? Did she do it? Yes, she did. She did what Sam told her to do. All the ugly, mean things she did to Louisa. Did Jayla apologize to Louisa? Did she? Yes, she did. She apologized to Louisa by saying, "I'm sorry." So who can stand up for you if someone is mean to you? Who can stand up for you? Your friends, a teacher, your parents? Have you ever thought about what you would do to stand up for someone? Let's share and talk about that right now in class. Three students, raise your hands and share. What would you do? Just one word. What would you do? Well, great job, everyone. But I'm going to tell you, there's one question that I have missing here. And let me tell you what that question is. Why did Jayla decide to change and stop daring Louisa to do the mean things that Sam was telling her to do? Why did she? Why did she stop? Do you remember when she was in bed and she was thinking about, what could I do? I don't like doing this. This is not me. That's what she said, right? But the main reason why Jayla stopped doing Sam's dares was because she was tired of being scared. And she had lost the good person that she was. All the things that she loved doing, she stopped doing because this person was being mean to her and then was having her being mean to someone else. Do you have to do something mean just because someone says so? No, you don't. So always think about that when someone tells you something mean to do, okay? So let's find out how you can be an upstander, how you, instead of a bystander, just standing by, watching things happen to someone without intervening or helping. So what can we do? Let's find out.
Threatens repeatedly.
So let's start here.
One in five children in the United States experience bullying where a peer harasses, humiliates, or threatens repeatedly. Bullying can have negative psychological, physical, and academic effects. It can contribute to depression, anxiety, low self-esteem, and it can be isolating. Most kids are not directly involved in bullying. They are a witness or a bystander to bullying. Sometimes bystanders get roped into reinforcing the bullying. This can make the situation worse and more traumatic. However, if a bystander becomes an upstander, then something really cool happens. When bystanders to bullying intervene, bullying stops within 10 seconds, 57% of the time. Think about it. If bystanders became upstanders every time there was a bullying incident, more than half of all kids would be spared a prolonged harmful experience, and they would feel the support of a peer. Kids with strong leadership qualities and who are self-assured are more likely to be on the defender role. So you are really like a peer superhero when you become an upstander. There are a number of ways you can shift the negative focus of bullying. Change the subject, interrupt, question behavior, use humor to lighten up a serious situation, embrace your differences, report bullying and block cyberbullying, protect others and show kindness and empathy, and include others in what you are doing.
Did you hear that? And I want to just repeat that a little. Go back up. I wanted you to see that. Change the subject, interrupt, question the behavior, use humor, embrace your differences, report the bullying or cyberbullying, protect, be kind to others, include others like your teacher, or an adult, a parent. So this is what you can do to distract, to stop the person from bullying someone else. These are just some suggestions.
What you are doing. Every time you stand up and stick up for others, you are making a positive difference and helping a peer who may really need a friend. To learn more about bullying prevention, visit stopbullying.gov.
So today, how many of you think that you can be an upstander? I know I can. I can be an upstander, and so can you. Can you be an upstander? Yes, you can. Did you learn ways today that you can be an upstander? I know you did. I heard you. I heard some of you say today that you want to be upstanders. Well, guess who being an upstander starts with? Being an upstander, like this young man here, starts with you, okay? So be an upstander. Most people are not bullies, but they are bystanders. If you see bullying, stand up for the ones who are being bullied, because bullying starts with being a bystander that intervenes starts with you. Remember that. Bullying can be intervened. You can stop it by being a bystander that helps others. It starts with you. I hope you've enjoyed the lesson today and you've learned one thing that you can take with you today for the rest of your life to help others that need help. Have a great day, everyone, and enjoy the rest of your day being bully-free. This has been Dr. BJ with another counseling lesson. Have a great day, everyone.